toxic pollution every single day of their lives. Often talk about carbon poisoning, but does not stop their babies from getting leukemia. And these are our neighbors. That's all. Thank you, Randy. So, I want to, number eight. Go ahead. So we're going to go here, here, and then we're going to come to you, Kim.
Yeah, I was going to let you make your announcement, Gary.
Oh, okay. Did you want...
Sit down.
Okay, go ahead.
When I'm listening to what you're saying, and I'm reminded of Scott Nearing. I don't know if you're familiar with him. He wrote a book called Twilight of Empire. He was an economist that he was tried for treason for writing an anti-war pamphlet in World War I. But in his book Twilight of Empire, he was an economist that studied the different cycles that all empires went through and when they collapsed. He was also called himself a revolutionary. He said it wasn't necessary to have a revolution in this country because it was going to collapse on its own accord. What seems to me that's happened is we've gotten to all the traditional points of an empire where you've developed a working class and an upper class that can't sustain itself, that has a demand level that can't feed itself, and it collapses. What looks to me that's happened that probably hasn't happened in the history of the planet is we're going to a corporate empire.
Right.
So we've transcended nation empires, feudal empires, to nation empires, to a corporate empire. But what we're trying to avoid in our mindset is that our empire has collapsed and our privileged lifestyle can no longer be sustained. And that's what people are really worried about. The median income of the world is $500 a year. And if you make $10,000 a year, you're part of the top 10% of the planet. If we look at ourselves, what a poverty level in this country is still the top of the rest of the world. In our struggle for our democracy and our constitution, is this a grasp to still hold on to a point of privilege where letting the empire collapse and having the simple lifestyle take over, which is traditionally what's always happened in the planet?
Well, it's a deep thing, so my quick reaction is this. All empires fall. This one will too. In fact, it is collapsing right now. However, what's different this time, there's a couple of differences, but one that I think is really important to acknowledge, and that is this. In the past, when empires fell, empires collapsed because of imperial overreach, right? And they consume and try to bring in, and it basically implodes on itself, right? And in the past, all the empires, what happened? Well, the people who survived just sort of wandered off into the forest or the mountains or the savannas or whatever the natural world was, and reconstituted themselves. This is the first time, I think you're right, Johnny, that this is a corporate empire, so it's not a nation state empire, which is quantifiably different, right? That's a huge thing. But here's the other thing that's different. This is a global empire. For the first time, there's no place to go. So this is my feeling. We are either going to, this empire will fall, but the question is whether it comes crashing down on us and itself in a cataclysmic, horrific way, or whether we can actually dismantle it and transition into another world. And that's what I'm trying to do, what we're trying to do in Move to Mend, to the best of our ability. And I also, before we turn it over to Kim, I want to actually just sort of conclude with a big, big picture observation. The kind of conversation that came up today, this is actually healthy. It's okay to have those kinds of fierce disagreements and grapple, right? This is the point. We're not taught how to do this. So we have to learn how to actually do this together. We have to be patient with one another. The question is not when we disagree, it's how we disagree. And honestly, I'm going to go one better. The question is not when I mess up and insult somebody or do something stupid, it's when I do it. And hopefully I've developed enough trust and loving relationship with you that you will forgive me for it and we can stay in the struggle together. Right? Because I promise you I will mess up. And and then I will try to do better. We are all better than the mistakes that we make. All of us. And I will ask for your forgiveness when I mess up, and I hope you will ask for mine, and I'm going to promise you this, I will give it. Right? I will give it. right? Because we've got to actually change the kind of dominator mindset that we have been steeped and stewed in. That's actually what a real peaceful, loving, nonviolent revolution would look like. Because I'm going to conclude with this, and I'm going to turn to Kim. Really, we got to incorporate love and compassion into our political organizing work to the very best of our abilities. I haven't been taught how to do that. I'm doing my best. And all I ask is that you do your best, too. Yeah.
It's a scenic tour.
Thank you so much for coming. ma'am, it's all fine.
Well, in that case, one more time, David, thank you so much.
Thank you. Now, if anybody wants to have a quick chat, I'll be, but I would encourage y'all to get together about a next meeting, right? To figure out how to continue to build on the momentum that is clearly in this room.
Amen, brother.